Yes, amen.
Amen. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. But there was a problem. It was dark. Void, waters was upon the face of the deep. It needed help.
Amen.
Amen. But it couldn't help itself, even though it was a creation of God. It couldn't help itself.
Amen.
It took God. Amen. The Bible said that God moved.
Yes.
Glory.
Yes.
The Bible said God moved.
Amen.
Amen. How many believe God still moves?
Yes. Yes.
If y'all pray for me, I need God to move.
Bless him, Lord.
I'll tell you that. All the way up here, I told my wife, I said, somebody else is going to have to preach. I prayed 3 hours today and I ain't got nothing. Amen, I'm telling you. But see, God's learned me.
Preach on nothing.
Amen. How many knows he knows you?
Amen.
He knows if he gives me a message early today, I'll mess it up. Amen. I don't ever get it to about church time or in church or somebody sings a song. Because if he gives it to me in the morning time, I'll start studying and twisting and turning. And I'll put man's touch on it.
Come on.
Amen. Man needs to keep his hands off of it.
Yeah.
Amen. You don't let men sitting all around you. There's men up and down the streets up through here. Amen. We need something from the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And I was like, God, don't you hear me? I've laid on my face all day. Ain't you going to give me a word for tonight? Find out, figured it out, friend. He didn't want me messing with him. Amen. His ways is higher than my ways.
Amen.
Amen. That's just how I am. I like to mess with things, don't you? But anyway, if you got your Bibles, turn with us to Psalms 122. Amen. I believe I'll just read one verse here. And as I came in here tonight, and I thought that I had nothing, but I had everything. Amen. See, when you walk with God and you do the best that you can and you trust him at all times, amen, you might feel like you're nothing. But as long as you got Jesus,
amen,
you're everything.
Yes.
Amen. He makes you everything. Amen. Psalms 122, verse 1. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Heavenly Father, I know that without you I can do nothing. But God, you've opened this door. You've brought us here. And I know that you're going to move. Lord, I trust you tonight. I honor you and I praise you. Anoint my lips of clay. Touch every heart and every ear. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
I began to think tonight, and I thought back to the four nights leading up to the night that I got saved. And on the first night, see, I'd never been to church. I never known anything about it. I went to one little Christmas play when I was about 10. But other than that, I was 22-year-old, dying on drugs, and didn't have any idea whatsoever how to get saved. I didn't know anything. But there was someone, I saw something in them, and they had joy, and they were happy. And they just had, no matter what they was going through, it seemed like you couldn't get these people down. Man, their cars was falling apart. Their homes was being took. He lost his job in the mines. He couldn't get Social Security. Everything around them was going down. But they was the happiest married couple I'd ever seen in my life. But anyway, one day they asked me to go to church with them. And I said, all right, I'll go. Now, after that first night at church, God began to deal with me a while ago how that I could remember. And that even though I was lost, and even though I was a drug addict, and I wouldn't yet save. But after that first night in church, and I'm talking about a Holy Ghost filled revival. Amen. A place not where man was shaken, but a place where God was shaken. Amen. After that first night, the next night, even I was on the outside looking in. Amen. I wasn't a Christian. I wasn't saved. But something made me glad that next evening. Something. Not because I was perfect. Not because I was forgiven. I hadn't even prayed. But something, when they said, do you want to go with us again? Something made me glad. Amen. And it wasn't because I had anything.
Yes,
but it was because they had something. They had something in that place.
Yes.
something that man couldn't give me. I was looking for something that the doctors couldn't give me. And they had it, church. They had that joy. They had that joy unspeakable for the glory. But tonight I thought, looking back, that I don't want to make the statement that I was glad.
Amen.
Amen. I don't want one of these days just find out that the church has died and everybody's joy has been stolen. We're just all sitting around in the house of God. And tonight maybe you can remember a time that you was glad. A time that you were filled with joy when it become Friday evening. That there was a time that you couldn't wait. Amen. Because no matter what, you know, even if you were sick, there was somebody that could heal you.
Amen.
If your family was lost, you know if you could just get to the house of God,
amen,
that your family could be saved. And I thought about the writer here, how that he wasn't writing because he didn't say I was glad. Because he had a perfect life. He didn't say that he was glad because he didn't have troubles. Woo, hallelujah. He didn't say he was glad to go to the house of God because he was problem free.
Amen.
He had problems. Amen. How many's got problems tonight?
Amen.
My Lord, you all pray for me. Amen. We've got problems.
Yes.
Amen. And now we slipped and we fall and we make mistakes and we get to the place that now our problems are telling us how we feel. Our problems is telling us how we act in church.
Bless
I remember the time, my Lord God, amen, when God baptized me with the Holy Ghost. I remember a time it didn't matter, amen, what was going on in my life.
Lord.
Amen. I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Glory.
What made me glad? Because I know in the house of the Lord, there was something. In the house of the Lord, amen, I had that faith that in the house of God, amen, sickness could be healed. In the house of God, sin could be forgiven.
Yeah.
In the house of God, God's people was rejoicing. And they were standing up, and they were standing against the devil. In the house of the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go. And I'm afraid that we're living in a time that the church is dying. And as we travel around, we go to different places. Where's that joy Brother Ferguson was talking about? Well, when you pray for somebody, it gives you joy. Why? Why does it give you joy to hear that somebody's got cancer? Why? Because when you take that one that's got cancer and you take them to Jesus and you believe that Jesus is the author and the finisher, and you believe that Jesus can do anything,
amen,
it gives you joy to put in that prayer request.
Yes, so, amen.
I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad.
Yes.
Amen. What happened to that? Where's that went to? Amen. Why ain't we glad no more? Amen. Instead of being down and out, murmuring and complaining like I was today all the way up through here. Oh, Lord, why ain't you going to speak to me? Oh, why didn't I cry? Well, I should have just been happy.
Bless the Lord.
Just to know that today, if not my Lord, just to know that today, if not any other day,
amen,
that before evening was out, for one day I would know that I would be entering into his house.
Amen.
Amen. Abraham, amen, when he come into the land of Canaan, amen, God had told him to go into the land of Canaan, and he went. The Bible said when he come in, he pitched a tent and built an altar there in Shechem. But then he come on down to another place between Hai and Bethel. Amen. And he built him an altar there. Amen. And you know what Bethel means? Bethel means the house of the Lord. Amen. You know what we need to get back to? We need to get back to the house of God. Amen. You can show up in the house of God, but yet not be glad that you're in the house of God. Woo, hallelujah. I tell you, I am glad when they said unto me, let us go. Let us go into the house of the Lord. There's many of you tonight, you have problems. Your problems may be different than my problems. But when we come together in this place, we come in unity. In this place, we love one another. In this place, we come together in faith. In this place, we ask and we shall receive. In this place, in the house of God, there is hope, church. There's hope for the marriage that's falling apart. There's hope for the financial trouble. There's hope for the physical sickness.
Amen.
In the house of the Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
But you know what kills me? It's when we go to the house of God and it's dead. Dead singing, dead preaching. Oh, I can't get anything out of it. I listen and I try to get a hold of something, but it ain't 30 minutes after church I've done lost it.
Amen.
Do you remember back when you used to get a hold of something? Amen.
Yes,
God
Lord.
Used to deliver something to you in every service, every revival, every time you went to church. Amen. You got a hold of something.
Come on, baby.
Woo! Hallelujah. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. But now, Walmart can keep me out. Amen. Birthday parties can keep me out. Amen. Little bitty sicknesses, headaches can keep me out. Amen. I believe if we would just strengthen ourselves a little bit, and I'm not preaching down on you for having headaches, I'm just telling you that God can heal you of a headache.
Woo, glory,
amen.
Yes,
there's
Lord.
A prayer line in the house of God.
Amen.
There's people that will anoint you in the house of God.
Yes.
And we'll get up, church. We'll get up and get back to the house of God.
Bless him, Lord.
I was glad when they told me. Do you think he wrote that and sung that because he had a perfect life? Was it David that wrote that one? Whoever it was, he had problems, didn't he?
Amen.
Whoever he was, he had issues and problems.
Yes.
He didn't write that. He wrote that because he learned something.
Da-da-da-da-da.
He learned that there is a place, hey, my Lord, woo! There is a place that people
yes.
can go to, that people can come together one night and one
Amen.
Accord. And I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Now when you think, on the day of Pentecost, man, I don't know where they were, 120 gathered together. Where were they at? They were in the upper room. But when God's people come together, let me tell you, it is the house of the Lord. He dwells right in here. And when we come together, it is the house of the Lord. Amen. But see, they were together. They loved each other. And they worked together. And they prayed together.
Woo,
and they
prayed
the house of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. And all of a sudden, the sound came from heaven.
Come on now.
That's what we need is that sound. I believe if the church would rise up, if the church would get up. See, Adam, when he was created, he was laying there. He was formed. God formed him. Hey, that was a little bit more than just creating. That means God touched him. He was touched and he was formed.
Amen.
But he was still just a corpse. He was just laying there. Amen. And if he would have been left in that condition, Gary, that body would have decayed. That body would have rotted. Adam needed life.
Wow.
And it took God breathing in his nostrils, the breath of life, and he would become the living soul.
Wow.
He needed something, and God had it.
Come on,
I believe we're living in an hour. The church needs something. The church needs that Holy Ghost fire.
Amen.
The church needs that breath of life.
Yes.
Amen. We're not a corpse. We're not dead.
Yes,
and I see how the body shut. We're not dead, church.
Amen.
We're not dead. And God's not dead.
Woo.
Arise
now. Oh,
let's make up our minds that we're glad when they say unto us, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Yes, amen.
See, I still believe in miracles. I believe that God can do anything. That's why you're glad when you can go into the house of God. God can work out anything. Trust him tonight and he can move on anything. Nothing is impossible.
Amen.
Nothing is impossible. When we pray and then we doubt. We pray and then we doubt in what we pray. I heard someone, I believe it was Brother Ferguson, said that when we pray and don't believe it, it's really a waste of time. It's really a waste of time. You remember back when you were glad? Why were you glad? Because you had faith.
Amen.
You know
yes.
that if all week at work, if everything went wrong, at home, if everything went wrong, and no matter what, if everything went wrong, you know this when Sunday come, if you could just get back to the house
Woo!
Of God,
Woo!
If you could get in there with your brothers and sisters.
Amen.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go. Amen. Let us go. And to the house of God. We've all got problems, but this is where they're going to be fixed. Let me tell you what the world won't do. Amen. First of all, the world won't get you on par with God. Facebook won't get you on par with God.
Amen.
My Lord, come on. TV will not get you on par with God.
Yes.
gossiping will not get you on par with God. But I tell you what will. Come into the house of God and get a hold of something. That'll get you on par.
Amen. Oh, preach.
Amen. Preach. I was glad when they said, let us go into the house of the Lord. Why don't we make some choices in our lives? Oh, if I could just make some choices. Oh, if I could just cleanse my hands and purify my heart. Amen, you double-minded. If we could just be singular-minded. Amen, if we could just have Jesus on our hearts and Jesus in our minds.
Yes.
And Jesus in our feet.
Woo.
And Jesus,
yes,
in our shelves. And Jesus in our churches.
Yes.
Purify our hearts.
Glory to God.
Draw nigh to God, He'll draw nigh to you.
Amen.
But then there's more. Bend your hands, you stand. Purify your hearts, you double-minded. Oh, church, I'm telling you, if you want revival, you know what? Too many people's getting saved, and they're getting falling back out.
Amen.
You know why? Because the church ain't got the spark they used to have.
Shut that
man, I'm telling you, when I first got saved, they was young people from one side of the church houses to the other. They were singing, getting filled with the Holy Ghost, and it made me hungry, and it made me thirsty. But now, it seems like there's been a falling away.
Bless Lord.
But you know what? God can do anything. I believe God can give us revival. I believe God can strengthen us. I believe God can put the fire back. Amen.
Yes.
If we all believe. Amen. God can do anything.
Yes, amen.
Let us. I was glad when they said unto me. Even when I was on the outside looking in, it made me happy. Why? Because they said Jesus could deliver me from drugs. They said Jesus could deliver from anything.
Amen.
They said nothing was impossible for this man. They said there was a man named Jesus. And you know what? They said He loves you. He loves you. No matter where you're at, He loves you. And they said He can deliver you.
Come on.
That was enough to make me glad. Because there was a place I could go to. Have you ever went to the bank for a loan? Amen. And you was happy on the way down there. Because you thought, my problems are solved. Glory to God, we're going to get along. Amen. I'm happy because we're going to the bank. And you get in there and they tell you, there ain't nothing we can do for you. Amen. There ain't nothing we can do for you. Have you ever went to somewhere and you really was needing something? But all of a sudden you found out there wasn't nothing they could do. Maybe you went to the doctor. And you was hoping for a good report. And you went in there and they said, there ain't nothing we can do. I bet these people sitting here tonight that's been healed. Not because of the doctor. Not because of the bank.
Amen.
But you've been completely healed.
Woo,
because
Lord,
of
yes,
the house of God. Because
woo,
God dwells among His people.
Come
on, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go.
Come on now.
We need to get going, church.
Amen.
We need to be a light set upon a hill. Amen. That mansion that cannot be hid. See, I believe that when God, see, the Bible said cannot be healed. Cannot be hid. Cannot be hid. Amen. People can talk about you. They can talk about you, church. They can do whatever they want to. But if you've got the glory of God in you, it will not be hid.
Amen.
Somebody's going to see it.
Amen. That's right.
Somebody's going to
yes,
see it. Satan can try to derail your ministry. Satan can work against you all he wants to. But let me tell you something. When a man or a woman gets a hold of God, amen, when you get a hold of God, you got a hold of something. And there ain't nothing can hide it.
Come on.
You will make full proof. Amen.
Come on now.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go. Amen. Let us go. Don't you want to get into the house of God? Don't you want to have joy unspeakable and full of glory? Amen. Don't you can't even talk about it. Jesus is so good you can't even speak about it. It's unspeakable. You try to tell people, but there ain't no way you can tell them just how good that Jesus is.
Yes, that's right. Amen.
Because we're glad. I mean, he's glad tonight.
Yes, amen.
Oh,
hallelujah.
Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. Let's get up and let's be happy.
Amen.
Amen. That we can go to the house of God.
Yes.
Amen. That when everything goes wrong, there's a place you can go to. You think about that woman with an issue of blood.
Woo.
She spent everything that she had. Her money was gone. Her hope was close to being gone. But all of a sudden, she heard about Jesus.
Amen.
She heard about Jesus. time that we get up, amen, and shake ourselves off and declare that our Redeemer lives.
Woo!
We're not giving up and we're not backing down, but we're going to the cross of God.
Hallelujah.
And we're going with hope.
Amen.
I need to lose weight. Amen, I do, and I ain't going to Richard Simmons or one of them to figure it out. I'm going to do like this, brother.
Bless him, Lord.
I'm going to ask God to help me.
Hey,
amen, I'm going to ask God to give me wisdom.
Amen.
God is the only hope in God.
Come on, brother.
Amen. We live in a day and time that anything in the world goes. They preach you can have all this sin in your life. Listen to this. Would you be glad to go into a house that couldn't help you with sin?
Yeah, come on.
How could it make you happy if you went in with sin sick and you went into a place that was just all right? Oh, I'm depressed. Demon spirits is oppressing me and I'm going to a place that's all right.
Him, Lord.
That's all right. You're still saved. That's all right. You think this, man. Amen. I'm glad they still highway of holiness. I'm glad they still people that preach and believe they still clean women. Because let me tell you something. Amen. When we live good for God, He moves.
Amen. Yes.
He moves that sin out.
That's right.
You don't have to live with that sin.
Glory.
You don't have to live with that iniquity. You don't have to live with that darkness. Let me tell you about the light. His name is Jesus.
Put
and He can help you.
Amen. Oh, yes.
Lord. I was glad. When they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Now, are you thinking back to when you used to be glad? Have you lost something? Has the enemy come in like they did old David there in Ziklag? See, sometimes when you're off somewhere you shouldn't be, the enemy attacks where you should be. Woo, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Sometimes when you're off where you shouldn't be, like David was when he was down there with the Philistines. Amen. But back home where he should have been. Amen.
Bless
the enemy come and burn all everything, took the wives and the children. Can you imagine coming home and your family being gone? Gone. Gone.
Come on.
And you're left. How many of you tonight's got family that's actually, they're gone. They're gone. Don't get used to them being gone.
That's right.
Don't satisfy with them being gone. Don't get used to that. Amen. Rise up like David did. Encourage yourself in the Lord. You know what we need? We need to be encouraged in the Lord.
Yes, amen.
Shall I pursue after you get encouraged, you can go after
him. Amen.
Take back what the devil took from you.
Preach.
Take back what the enemy took
Woo,
from you.
Glory.
Woo, hallelujah. Amen. When the battle of the kings was going on, and David was king, but he wasn't at the battle of the kings. See, when he was should have been at the battle of the kings, he was on top of his house taking a break. And guess what happened? Trouble. See, trouble comes when we're out doing something we shouldn't be doing. But how many knows God still forgives? God still forgives you, and He can redeem you.
Amen.
Are you glad when they say unto you, let us go into the house of the Lord?
Yes, amen.
Oh, I feel that.
Praise
let
God.
Us go unto the house of the Lord. We should not be miserable people. We should be full of joy, church.
Yes.
Full of joy.
Amen.
My Lord.
Come on. Thank God.
Preach.
But our hungers and our desires have shifted. Amen. Now, it's the things of the world that does the things of the world make us happy? Is it the things of the world that makes us glad? If it is, we need to get on the altars. Because Abraham, when he come back up out of Egypt, he should have never been in Egypt. Amen. He should have trusted God in the famine. But instead, he went down into Egypt, lied about who his wife was, got in trouble. But when he come back, you know where he went right back to? Right back to Bethel. Right back to where he had built the altar. In Genesis 13, if you want to read it, he went back to where he had built an altar before. And I mean, some of you know what it is to build an altar with God. You know what it's like to be glad and to be full of joy. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Yes.
Do you know what it's like to be full of the joy of the Lord?
Amen. Yes.
See, the world has to be happy. Good things have to happen for the world to be happy. They win the lottery, they're happy. Amen. They lose their house, they're sad. God's people see happiness and joy through different things.
Amen.
Happiness results from circumstances. Woo, hallelujah.
All right.
Something good happens and you're happy. That's what the world needs. But joy, I can have joy. Amen. I can count it all joy. I can count it all joy when I fall into divers temptation, knowing that the trying of my faith work with patience. God's always working with his children.
Amen.
So we can have joy tonight. We can be glad.
Yes.
Amen. Don't you want to get on fire?
Amen.
Don't you want that Holy Ghost? I know we had good service here tonight, but there's more.
Amen.
Amen. I know we felt good. I know we shaped it down. And I know it was real. I can feel God in this place. But I believe we can get on par in such a way that the law starts seeing it.
Yes.
And they start wanting it. And they say, I don't know what they got, but I'm going to go see.
Yes, hallelujah.
And then we can have revival.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Gloria, da, da, da.
Was she glad the first week you got saved? Can you remember what it felt like? Trying to get to church, how happy you was. The devil was fighting you. Everything in the world was probably fighting you. But you thought, if I could just get there, if I could just get to God's house. One of these days, we're going to leave this old world. We're going to go to God's big house.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You're talking about glad. Amen. You're talking about rejoicing. But he that endureth unto the end, the same shall be saved.
Yes,
now, he didn't tell me I had to endure with a frown. He didn't tell me I had to endure murmuring and complaining.
Bless
it said,
Lord.
He that endures unto the end, the same shall be saved. I don't have to have a muddy grudge, as God calls it. Amen. I can endure it with a smile.
Amen.
I can endure it with the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Woo, bless.
Amen. I love you all. Come on. I love Brother Gary. I love this church. And I believe that God will give you revival. Amen. I believe that. But we got to be glad.
Amen.
That's got to be the number one thing. When we wake up in the morning, I can't wait to get to God's house. Amen.
Come on.
I can't wait to get to God's house. My mom, she don't understand. She don't understand why we travel to go to church. And she's like, well, can't you just wait till Sunday? You have church on Sunday. She don't get it. She don't understand that it is a joy. It's a joy to go to church.
Amen. Right. Yes, it is.
Amen. And it's a joy to see people shout.
Amen.
Amen. I get blessed when people dance before the Lord. Amen. Can you imagine David when he danced with all his heart?
Yes.
Amen. He danced until his clothes come off. His wife didn't understand it. Woo! Let me tell you something. He understood it.
Yes.
How many of you tonight, you understand what I'm talking about?
Yes,
come
on now.
You understand it, don't you?
Amen.
To dance before the Lord with all your heart. Amen. I sure didn't have this plan.
Come on.
Good. I thought I was going to get somebody else to preach. But when the service started, I remembered it. I was glad when they said unto me, even as a sinner, because there was hope in that place. There was no hope in the bars. There was no hope in the drug dealer's house.
Right?
All I could get in the world was the same stuff I'd been getting.
Yes.
Amen. There wasn't no hope in that. But it was God's people that was carrying the candle.
Yes.
Amen. I feel that. It was God's people that was carrying the candle. They were the one carrying the light.
Da, 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 da.
And I saw something in them.
Yes.
I saw something in them.
Amen.
And it gave me hope. And wherever they went, I wanted to go with them.
Amen.
Because I believed that if they got a hold of it, then I could get a hold of it. Amen. He loves you tonight. But I believe that he wants to restore your joy. He wants to restore your faith. Your faith to bring joy. Amen. He wants to restore you. Wake you up. Amen. Wake you up and restore your joy. And that joy will get people saved, church. Love one another.
Amen.
Amen. And I'll turn it back over to you, Pastor. God bless each and every one.
Bless the Lord.
Egypt. They come to that Red Sea. Now God moved for them. How many of us have failed God? He's never failed us. He's never come up short. But how many times have we come up short?
Amen.
How many times have we let him down?
Right.
Come on.
The fields are full and ripe and ready to harvest. But where are the workers?
Oh, my.
Where are the people?
Yes, him, Lord.
Where's God's people that's going out and showing that joy he was telling us about? Going out and telling them about this Jesus.
Amen.
Why are we not doing this? Why are we not spreading the word of God?
Come on.
Why are we letting him down? I've let him down so many different times.
Amen. Bless
him. Oh, I've lost that joy. Oh, I know what it's like. Oh, it talks about Lazarus there, he's dead. And they questioned God, said, you're late. No, Jesus, you're 4 days late. But he was still on time. Every time I get in that position where I'm down, not questioning God, where are you? Why haven't you come through for me? I know that he is working still.
Amen.
And our ways are not his ways. He knows better.
Yes.
Oh, thank God for that message. I ain't going to preach to you. I'll let Gary have an altar call here.
Bless him, Lord.
Come on, Sherry.
Bless you.
You know, I was thinking when they were singing about Jesus, he's a friend of mine. That name Jesus, there's nothing that beats that name Jesus. I've been listening and reading to things, and I love these messages that get into the Hebrew teachings and how much insight it gives into the word and understanding. But can I tell you, the name Jesus, that's enough to preach right there. That's enough to talk about. The name Jesus never gets old. The blood never gets old. You never go past anybody's head when you talk about the name Jesus. That name has so much power. I tell people all the time, watch your words, because words have power. But there's never been such a word as the name of Jesus that has power. When I was growing up, I was like, Brother Pete, I didn't know nothing about church. But I heard something about a man named Jesus. And whenever I went into a revival, a Holy Ghost revival, they were talking about a man named Jesus, honey. And I was at the end of my ropes. I was afraid to be left alone, afraid I was going to take my own life, and I couldn't control it no more. The drugs had a hold of me. Depression had a hold of me. But they told me, Jesus, it wasn't nothing more than that. They
Ashby. And we all woke up and they done the echo. Woo! Jesus had a hold of me. It's still simple. It's Jesus Christ. There ain't nothing else we need. Just Jesus. We gotta get back to the blood. Get back to the cross. Forget all the fancy stuff. Forget about looking all good for church. Cause it don't matter. I come for Jesus, not nothing else. I want to hear Jesus. I want to see Jesus move. Tell me about the blood. Cause that's all I need in this life is Jesus. And I'm thankful for it tonight.
Oh, my.
Hold on.
Brother Gary Starr's church. Since I was 5 years old, I've suffered with migraine headaches. But severe ones that kind of put me in the bed. And a few weeks ago, God completely healed me of those headaches.
Yes.
And not only did he heal me of those, but he healed me of severe anemia.
Thank you, Jesus.
Why don't we just raise our hands and just praise God, would you? Thank the Lord. Amen. Let's just pray for folks. Let's just worship. Amen. Just let God have his way. Don't be ashamed. Pray the Lord. Let God have his way. In a good way. I thought about Brother Pete's saying, I was glad when they set us over in the house of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And I thought about that in a few minutes. Why should we be glad to go into the house of the Lord? Not everywhere you go is the house of the Lord.
Amen.
And it's a house of man, house of religion.
Right.
Here, amen.
Man controls us in the Holy Ghost. But I thought, you know, why should I be happy? Because the Bible makes us a promise that where two or three are gathered together, church means assembling of people.
Amen.
And here, he promised us that he would be in the midst. Talk to me, sometimes in everyday life and world's cares out there, it's hard to feel him. It's hard to find him.
Come on, man.
It's hard to come in contact.
Yes.
I mean, if you lay on your bed at night and say, Lord,
where are you?
Lord, let me know that you're still with me.
Amen.
But God said, I'll make you a promise. If you'll go to my house, you'll come together. Somebody raise your
hand.
I'm not trying to move. I'm just a man here disturbing my heart. Amen. He said, I promise you, I'll be in the midst. No wonder Jacob got a stir in. Amen. To leave Uncle Laban's house and go all the way back and went through hell and high water.
Amen.
To get back to Bethel, which means the house of Yah. Now, the second thing. Why was it glad to go in the, you got me stirred up around the creek. You know, in the Bible. Amen. But why is it rejoicing and glad? Amen. Because listen to this. There is nowhere in this world that has a sure foundation.
Amen.
Come with me here. But friend, when you step in the church of the living God, Jesus spoke it from his own lips. Amen. Upon this rock, I'll build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. Man, y'all with me here? Come on, saints of God, with me here. If we're truly in the Lord's church, amen, there is not enough demons, there is not enough devils. Come on now. Look. Let me just give you another. Here comes another. Somebody say, hang loose.
Hang loose.
Amen. Hang loose right here. Look at it. Amen. In the world, and this is everywhere, folks, with me. Somebody told me this week, some young person told me, and they said, preacher, you know, when I get out, I have to go and be around, you know, people. Said, all I hear is cussing. And they're cussing, and he said they're just cussing. You know how it is in the world, even though you don't want to be around. Not even, come on, you're not even involved with it. Amen. You just walk among ordinary people, and they're using the filthiest of language. Don't do it. You turn on the television, they're cussing and swearing.
Come on. Oh.
And even so on Facebook, talk to me here.
Now,
you're not going to be here.
Yeah.
That's everywhere. But one thing, if you go into the Lord's house and to the Lord's church,
amen,
you're going to hear holy,
woo,
holy to the Lamb,
yes,
of God.
Amen.
Come on, folks, you're going to hear praises. No, no wonder. He said, yes, it's glad. He said, I was glad when they,
yes,
said, let's go into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. You know, you're going to the house of the Lord. Should hear a lot of bitterness,
right,
a lot of envy, a lot of strife.
Amen, yeah.
Now, when you talk to me here, amen. Well, you sisters was getting in tonight, I thought I'd take an offer, send you back to Tennessee because we got the Lord out there.
Hey,
somebody going to help me here? Amen. God, we're going to, Brother Pete, come up here with me. We're going to pray for folks. Amen. With the help of the Lord, folks. Listen to me. But now, let's leave that aside right here. And I really felt like this thought come to me today and this afternoon. And that is, what got the prodigal's attention?
Right.
Brother, what got that prodigal's attention? Don't with me, folks.
Father, sir.
That left the father's house, left the father's blessings, left all that peace and all that satisfaction. Amen. What got his attention? Got him looking back towards the father's house.
Amen.
The Bible teaches us, amen, that how that he went down into a far country.
Come on.
How that in many ways he's living on righteous living. With me here. Then the Bible said there was a famine coming in his life.
Right.
But that didn't get his attention. With me here, he joined himself with a stranger of that country. With me here, that didn't get his attention. Amen. The Bible said he went down, amen, to the hog lot, hog pen, began to feed the hogs. Seemingly that didn't get his attention. But this is what got his attention. Something within.
Come on.
Thank you, brother. Amen. You're with me. Something within that got his attention. The Bible said, he said, why would perish? And you're with me? In my father's house, he's got hard service. In other words, they're living better than eating better than I am.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you what gets the ball. Amen. Those are backed up on the grace of God and of the Lord is when that hungry pain begins to
come. Glory.
I used to feel it.
Bless the Lord.
Y'all with me here? I used to feel it. He used to talk to me. Y'all with me here? I used to have a relationship with him. Why with me here? And I believe there's hungry pains here tonight.
Yes,
I believe there's hungry pains. You know, you can't, how many of you have ever been hungry? Come on now, y'all. How many's been hungry? Come on now. How many of you been so hungry you lay in the bed? You just have to get up and get you something. Anybody ever been so hungry you just got up and go up and get you something?
Amen.
Well, that's all of us. But here, that's the same way spiritual.
Amen.
Talk to me. Amen. Nothing, but I don't care what it is. When you're hungry, you can do all the drinking you want to do, and it will not feel that void.
Amen.
Talk to me. We're going to pray, folks. I really felt God laid this on my heart. Amen. You know, you don't have to have somebody come and tell you. I don't have to come to you and say, Darrell, you look hungry. I thought little Eddie said, Twin, they got hungry. Am I hungry? No. Don't, is everybody, I mean, you don't have to have, I don't have to have Brother Tackett come and say, Darrell, you look hungry. Or, you know, you don't have to have any Brother Gordon, somebody walk, come and say, are you hungry? Hello? Folks, you know it for yourself.
Yeah, come on.
Come on now. And you know if you're hungry spiritually. You know if you're hungry for the Lord. And the Lord is what he's saying. I want you to stand with me all over this building tonight. I'm going to slip up on stage. I'm going to have this wonderful preaching.